The robot lawnmower of our dreams has finally arrived, and it's the LUBA AWD 5000, and it's a whole different vibe from our last robot lawnmower. And in this video, I'm going to review it for you. Hey y'all, hey, it's Ashley Renee, and it's been a minute. Kind of been busy growing a whole human over here, but I wanted to pop on to share a robot lawnmower update. Last time I did a video on robot lawnmowers, I was using one that required the setup of a perimeter wire, which I ran into issues with over time because the wire was not buried deep enough by the installer and it got cut several times during landscaping projects. So we've been waiting on a really dope one that was wire free to hit the market, and one finally did. It is the LUBA AWD 5000, and the AWD series is actually the first and only perimeter wire free robot lawnmower that can handle complex lawns up to 1.25 acres with a 37 degree slope. So the first mower I got, I actually paid for out of pocket, but this one was actually sent to me. All opinions are my own. So let's talk about it. First things first, what's in the box? So when you order your LUBA, you'll get everything you need inside. You don't need to purchase anything extra. Everything's in the box. It comes with the LUBA itself, the charging station, the power supply, the mower mat, the RTK reference station, the extension cable and the power supply for that, and an extra blade, the key installation kits, mounting pole, and a quick start guide. All right, so let's talk about the setup. So unlike my last lawnmower, which required the setup of a perimeter wire, this uses no such thing. It actually uses instead what's called an RTK mapping system, which can map out your lawn and set up various mowing zones without you having to dig or bury any wires at all. With RTK, basically, it's used to increase the accuracy of the GNSS signals by using a fixed base station, which wirelessly sends out connections to a moving receiver, which really all you need to know is this means that its accuracy is stellar. So this is the RTK base station, and it does not need to be connected to the charging station. You can actually just put the charging station anywhere you want, and this is where we put ours. Okay, so once that's set up, you just download the app and you use it to map out your perimeter of your yard. So I downloaded it and I just walked with the mower around my yard, and I kind of used my phone like it was like a video game controller, and I just navigated it along the perimeter. And once that was done, it was ready to go. So a little bit more about the app. What is smart technology without an app? So for this, you would download the Mowmotion app, which lets you customize your mowing tasks and track your mower's activities in real time, no matter where you are, whether you're at home, you're out running errands, you're at work, you're on vacation, wherever, it doesn't matter. It does not need your presence in order to work. So the app actually has a number of features. You can automate the schedule of when it comes on and which days, set up mowing tasks for different zones of your yard. You can check the mower status and even control the cutting height for each mowing zone. You can also create no-go zones, which basically, let's say you wanted to avoid your garden area or your kids' play area, you can make sure LUBA avoids those specific areas. Okay, mowing the lawn. So most importantly, does it work? That's what everyone really wants to know, right? Like, does it do the job and does it do it well? Yes, and that should be no surprise considering how well built this thing is. Don't get it twisted. Don't let its appearance fool you. I know it looks like a toy car. My two-year-old son Beyond certainly thought it was, but this is sturdy. It has a double cutting plate with a 16-inch cutting width, four powerful in-hub motors, off-road tires, and suspensions. It has excellent traction and can easily handle steep slopes, challenging terrain, and even thick, tall grass without fumbling. And it'll mow in precise straight lines. Like, it's not just gonna go all over the place randomly. It has a planned route algorithm that makes the mowing more efficient, and it just makes your yard look chef's kiss. And like I mentioned, you're not limited to just one part of your yard. You can do the backyard, the front yard, the side yard. It can manage multiple zones as long as there's a path between these zones in your yard. Now for us, because our backyard is fenced off from the front yard, we can just open the gate on the days we schedule our LUBA to mow, and we just close it back once it's done. Charging the battery. Like I said earlier, this comes with a charging station, a power supply, and a mower mat. Now, when the LUBA is done doing its thing, it just automatically goes back to its little charging station and recharges its batteries. Like if you have a robot vacuum cleaner, for example, you'll be familiar with how that works. It has a lithium ion battery that allows LUBA to run for up to about 3 hours. And when the battery gets low, it just knows to automatically return to its charging dock. And it gets more juice, and then it just gets right back to finishing the job. Last but not least, here are just some other interesting features I want to point out. First, it has automatic rain detection. If LUBA is in the middle of mowing the lawn and it starts to rain, it can handle that, which is pretty dope. It has these itty bitty little sensors right at the top of the mower, and as soon as it starts raining, it'll detect those raindrops automatically, go back to the charging dock, and start charging. Two, it also has anti-theft technology, because I know some of y'all are like, can't someone see it and just be like, oh, I'm gonna take that because nobody's around? No, it doesn't quite work like that. So the app will actually send out an alarm to notify you whenever there's any like movement that's out of the ordinary. And it even has a lost feature where you as the original owner would be notified of the current position of the lost LUBA when it reconnects to the network. And it actually cannot be used by someone else if you have not granted permission for it to do so. Three, smart obstacle avoidance. I kind of touched on this earlier with the no-go zones, but basically it has radar sensors that allow the robot mower to automatically detect and avoid obstacles that are in its way, even really small ones. I'm talking as small as 2 inches, y'all. You have a dog, a kid running around, your kid's toys laying around, it's smart enough to avoid. Final thoughts. Okay, so listen, we've been waiting on something like this to come out on the market for a while now, and it did not disappoint. A robot lawnmower in general is a time saver, especially for my husband, because he doesn't have to mow the lawn anymore, which means more time he's spending with our little family. And if you pay for lawn service, eventually you actually end up getting your ROI, so it'll save you money over time. And I like the LUBA specifically because it doesn't use wires. Some of y'all were trash talking me on my last video about the issues I was having with the wires of my last robot lawnmower. But you know, it is what it is. I wanted a wireless one, and I got a wireless one, and I'm happy with it. It works well, it's easy to use, the RTK mapping system is great, and I don't have to worry about replacing or repairing wires that, have gotten cut. I've got a little one on the way, and this is just one less thing for me and my hubby to manage, so we can just direct our attention to our growing family. So anyway, I'm curious, like, what are your thoughts on a perimeter wire-free robot lawnmower? Currently, it is on the Mowmotion website, listed at $2,899, which is actually less expensive than the one that I paid for, the Husqvarna automower, when that one first hit the market, which requires a boundary wire, unlike this one. So this wire-free robot lawnmower, is it something that you'd get for yourself at this particular price point? Let me know in the comments, and meanwhile, I'm just gonna be over here waiting for this new human to arrive in the world. As always, if you enjoyed this video, like if you like, sub if you love, and to keep up with me on a more frequent basis, you can actually feel free to just hit me up on Instagram. Thanks for watching, y'all.